goes. It has nothing to do with that ball. If it did, guarantee she'd be gone. Well.
Yo, 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 it's your girl Tasha, aka Fantastic.
The great one, El Boogie.
How y'all doing today? I just came back from my biker club.
Mm-hmm. She's smelling like motorcycle exhaust.
You know I like to ride.
Actually,
are we
if you go back on some of the other episodes, she doesn't like to ride.
I like to ride bikes.
Okay.
Motorcycles.
Okay. I'll let her
not
tell that.
Dick.
Already.
What? You tried to come for me.
Mm-mm. I just said
that doesn't embarrass me, though.
What? I'm not trying to embarrass you, huh?
Don't embarrass me that I don't fucking ride. My knees ain't built that way, so.
You just haven't met the right person.
What the? He better
the
be.
Right,
yo, he better be somebody special. That's all I fucking know.
The right
for me
person
to get on top.
The right person to say, playing all these games and get on. That's what she needs, y'all.
Who are you talking to?
Be demanding.
I don't need nobody that demanding.
Stop playing these games and get on. That's
nah,
what
we ain't do that. Now, you if you want me to get on your face, I'll gladly do that.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure she'll do that.
I'll hover that motherfucker, but.
Anyway, good to see y'all. What's the day, Friday?
Yeah.
Good to see y'all this Friday.
TGIF, bitches.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all better. Oh, I got a party tonight.
Yeah?
Yeah. A masquerade party.
I had a party, actually, too. My aunt is, I'm turning another year older. I'm not sure on the number, so I'm not going to say it. But
I understand.
Her daughter's having a little get-together.
I got my mask for my masquerade.
You've been wearing it already, haven't you? Thought she's going to assault me, y'all.
Yeah, I have been wearing a mask, right? But no, I got to go get my nails did, and I got to go get my hair retwisted. Because it's looking rough. The trip really messed my hair up.
That's good money. You got bread sticks right there.
It's called paycheck. It's called that paycheck.
I hear that.
It ain't nothing. It ain't nothing extra. I wish it was. I'm going to start playing the lottery and manifesting me winning. That's what I'm about to start doing.
There you go. Speaking into existence.
Yes. Play. I think something big right now. Be Powerball Omega.
Yeah.
I play both. $10 each. $10
you
each.
Hit, you know what I mean?
Oh, we in the money.
Mm-hmm.
What? You don't think I'm going to look out?
Yeah, you probably look out for me. You probably give me a new cell phone.
What?
Something like that.
No, man. We gonna get a studio.
That's what's up.
We gonna have good, like, fucking gamer chairs.
Oh, shit.
And we want a mic that can come to us while we leaning the fuck back. You know what I'm saying?
Man, I don't want... I tell you, we going out like that. I don't want a gamer chair. Give me one of them, one of them joints at the nail salon. I want one of them massage chairs. I want to do my podcast from a massage chair.
I cannot. Extra.
With Terry
just
down
so
there
extra.
Doing my feet.
I'm definitely going to give me a new, a nice car. I'm moving.
Yeah. No, you going to stay here.
I don't want to live here.
Buy the building.
I'm going to get, like, I was about to say, Lord, I was about to say raped. I don't know why I said.
The fantasies.
I don't know
stop,
why I was
y'all.
Thinking that.
Oh, my God.
I don't know why I was thinking that. I was about to get robbed. But
she
I just.
Awful porn hub or these websites. Because I don't know what she be watching, but
I just like the doggy style position.
Anyway,
I have a lot of clips.
Moving right along.
Saved in the spank bank.
Yeah. And you hit that money. I just want me a
new car.
A new car and a recliner.
A recliner, that's it.
Oh, that's just day one.
That's it. Well, damn, how much am
I
winning? But for that, you might as well just come up with me and claim half.
No, I'm gonna be holding the other end of the check like El Boogie with the hoodie. And
I'm gonna be one of them extra people like, yeah, what's up? Just all my haters. They didn't believe in me. I'm rich, bitch. Fuck y'all.
He's gonna die, y'all. I'm telling you.
Come find me, bitch.
Yeah, I'm going to. I'm not even gonna buy a house. I'm gonna, if I was a hit, I'm just gonna ride cruise ships for the rest of my life. I'm gonna get off of one and get right on another one.
I don't know, man. I've thought about opening a business. I always wanted a laundromat.
A laundromat?
Yeah. But I want, see, my laundromat is like, as long as you wash and dry your clothes, I wanted like a section for kids. Because, you know, we take kids, they run around and stuff, have like a little arcade. And they can play in like the little arcade
these
area.
These kids don't know what an arcade is? Oh my God, I'm going to ask my kids, y'all want to go to the arcade? Dad, what are you talking about? What's the arcade?
That's fucked up, yo.
What's the arcade?
Arcade used to be the spot. Especially in South Hand Mall.
It was.
Right next to the movie theaters.
It was.
That was the shit. All the time.
I was going to say something, but I don't want to ruin some
sponsorship. They know what, they go to David Buster's. They know what a damn arcade
is. No, they don't. They know it's called David Buster's.
They never been in the arcade section.
It's not called an arcade. It's called an entertainment section.
They got the new fashion district.
I haven't been there.
Next to the movie theater. It's a really nice arcade. Really nice. Okay. It's all the way up on the third floor, though. But it's really nice.
Chuck E. Cheese is the only arcade they know.
Chuck E. Cheese is sad. Like, the food is sad. It's like, it's just sad. Like,
oh, that sponsorship went down. Well, they ain't doing nothing anyway.
They not. It's like one fucking Chuck E. Two. It's one down Delaware, and then it's one up on the boulevard. Yeah. That's only two in Philly.
It's sad. I went to Chuck E. Cheese, and he had a gray beard like me. I said, damn, life is rough.
Man, Chuck E. Cheese don't even want to take pictures with the fucking kids no more. Because we talking about having Chuck E. Cheese for Aiden for his first birthday.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, I don't know. You know, he may love it, but Chuck E. don't even be wanting to touch none of the kids. He be sitting there like, what's popping?
It's all the shit in the suit.
Shit in the suit. Yo, but them darn drones that be on the stage, they creepy as fuck.
Oh, the group, the monsters.
Because them, their eyes be fucking moving and shit. I'm like, somebody in this bitch?
Somebody got to tell me this. Why, it's Adam Green say, why we black folks, why they let the kids go up there on that stage with Chuck, you know, they be behind the monsters.
They don't be caring.
Keisha, why you let your kids go up there?
They let them kids run free. And tire their ass out.
And then broke one of the monster's arm off. He don't even play the guitar right. You know what I mean? What's up with that?
Sit there.
Why we let our kids run free like that? We just be happy that they... Go ahead. No. Get away from
Same thing when you go to an amusement park. You know, let them run fucking free. Hey, gonna go.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Why are we on the topic of amusement park? Are you taking your nieces and nephews? Like, amusement park is a dangerous place to go now, man.
I mean, like Sesame Place and stuff.
Like, get people falling off of rides. And
well,
all
that
kinds of
yeah,
stuff,
that's
you know?
Crazy. Well, see, I take my kids are little, so they go to Sesame Place, like right. Funplex, where there's only like really one entrance and one in and one entrance out.
Would you get on a roller coaster today?
Where?
Anywhere. Six Flags.
If I could fit it.
You would get on?
I would.
Alright, well.
I used to love me some roller coasters. It was when I was 17.
Put me on your insurance policy.
It was when I was 17 I stopped getting on roller coasters because, you know, like I said, I'm top heavy. And I was at Dirty Park and I got on this ride and the thing kept popping up. And they like literally came and told me like,
what thing?
The bar.
Oh, the overhead.
Yeah, the overhead joint. It kept popping up. And it was like no lock. So it was just like, just come down and click, 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 click. And because I have the girls, Thelma and Louise, you know, they came to me first and was like, ma'am, I'm sorry. You know, it keeps popping up. And I'm like, how the hell you know it's me?
Because they got, it's the thing that tells them what row is the thing popping
up. That was,
up.
Yeah, I know. I got off and it worked.
Well, guess what? You seen all the Final Destination movies, right?
Yeah,
that was a blessing that you, because imagine if it didn't go all the way down.
It wasn't
down.
Going upside down or when nothing.
It, yeah, but you, there's some things, listen.
I don't have a problem with roller coasters. I love them. If I die, I'm going with a smile on my
you
face.
You
want to
die on a roller coaster? You
it
come
would be
off,
quick.
No, you come off like something, you want to die in the bedroom or something like that. You don't want to die on a roller coaster.
Like during sex?
Yeah, that's how you want to die.
I do want to die like
that's
that.
A shame.
That is. I want to just have that. Ah!
No, you probably would have died like.
I have a gag reflex.
Oh, God. Anyway, that's why I went off camera. But, of course, she's going to. I can't.
We keep it real.
I can't with her.
My gag reflex is not strong. So I'm going to like that shit. I don't.
Anyway, we're going to segue into the topics because she'll go on and on.
I will. When we start talking about
this stuff.
I don't give a fuck. He just say this because his kids watch.
Absolutely. You went after Midnight L?
Yes.
Are you kidding me?
Come on,
me?
Keep it no, fat funky. No, I can't. That's because he's a dad. See, this is why I'm saying dad shit.
We won't be raunchy. I'm telling you, it won't be nice.
Who?
After Midnight L. You know how After Midnight L
is. I know how After Midnight L is.
My daughters will be like, what the hell was dad talking about?
What? You'll just terrify them. And they know not to fuck with you.
They already know. They know After Midnight L, believe it or not.
Your kids know because you keep it real with your kids.
I do.
Let's you keep it funky. Stop acting
with
like
these
you don't.
Topics.
Topics. Real quick though, what do you think about the ASAP Rocky Rihanna?
I have no clue. I'm an old man when it comes to.
Well, it's rumored that he cheated, but they've been spotted together, so they seem as a rumor. I think Drake started the rumor. He has enough money where he could get that going. He's so hurt. Okay. He's so heartbroken.
Can I ask a question though?
What?
If he did, just hypothetically, if he did. Mm-hmm. What's it have to do with anybody else but them?
Okay, but they're celebrities. So it's a gossip. So we just talk about it at the airport coming back from our trip.
Oh my God.
Like, it was the topic of the table. So does anybody, what everybody think of? I'm like, damn. Everybody has
ain't nothing answers. We can do about it.
It's nothing we can do about it. I do feel like I love Rihanna to death. I think I love her. Big fan. To me, I feel like maybe she's settled, but she knows him, not me. So maybe she loves him.
They gotta work that out.
They do gotta work that out.
When there's a child involved, like you, I don't think that you should throw everything away based upon that because you're not just making a decision for you're making a decision for child. You know what I mean? So.
But I don't think it did, because supposedly it was some kind of shoe designer for her Fenty company.
Oh, come on.
And, you know, that's why I said, like, Drake did it. He been so booty hurt. But he did. I think he's a player.
Let's say this. As a celebrity, they go through a whole lot of...
drama.
No, ASAP probably deflects just because he's with Rihanna. So many women want to know what's about him. Mm-hmm. That he got Rihanna. So,
yeah, that's always going to be the biggest thing.
Let's go.
I don't know. Drake is definitely toxic.
You love Drake, so cut it
off. I don't love Drake. I love The Weeknd.
No, you said your threesome would be. You said Chris Brown.
I said Chris Brown and Drake, didn't I?
And Drake, yeah.
Yeah.
Yellow boys.
But honestly, I don't even think I would want Chris Brown anymore.
Why?
You know, I'm not a fan of Trey Songz. I already get women, so. I'm not down for that. You put your hands on me, you dying.
So you're going to go to jail for some
I'm not going
that.
To run.
Us big people can't run.
There's nowhere to
hide. Ain't nobody going to hide it.
That's a new card. What is it? No, what is
mm-mm.
it? Can I see it?
No, I'm not can talking I about that. I'm not talking about that. No. No, that's you gonna were... be the final podcast. So not tonight. Nope.
You take got another one. Oh my God.
Put that in the deck, but I ain't talking about that. Mm-mm. Okay. Weaves versus wigs.
Okay. Well, I don't do either. I'm growing locks. But I would wear a lace wig. Like, if someone wanted to make me a custom one, you know, shout out to all the sisters out there that do that. I'm down for it. I would like to see what a bitch would look like with a wig, you know. But I prefer definitely a lace wig than a weave.
Okay. You know? A lot of women in my family have worn wigs. My mom wears wigs. Mm-hmm. Shout out to the wiggers.
My grandma wore wigs.
Yeah, you know, and you know, from what I hear, as you get older, you have hot flashes, and they become microwave plates under the wigs.
He's such an ass.
Now, the other side of the coin is with weaves. As you get older, you have hot flashes. You can't take them out.
No.
So if I had a preference, I mean, whatever makes a woman feel good about herself. You go for what makes you feel good about yourself. I'm sure over the years, the way people put in weaves, you know, it's not a whole lot of the glue thing as much as it used to be back
in
the day.
No, it's more sewing now. They don't really do
right,
glue.
It's a lot more sewing and this, that,
but
and
you can
other.
Actually put a weave up. Like, they can put it up in a ponytail right. Where it looks like it's their hair.
Right, and the quality of hair, even
so
though it costs.
So much better.
Hair is a serious industry, even though it costs more, and I don't know that because my daughter is like an expert on
bundles. She
on
got that
bundles.
Virgin Malaysian.
Yeah,
blend.
She knows it all.
Yeah, let me get the virgin Malaysian with blend.
Anything about hair, my daughter knows
about. That's good.
About.
She's going to school to do hair, right?
She would like to.
She should.
You
should. If that's where your passion is and that's where your talent is, do it.
Right.
Which daughter is it?
But you, Layla.
Layla.
But you gotta.
You hear me, girl?
Anyway, before we was interrupted by the coyote.
That was a hyena.
Same thing spelled backwards. Yeah, I don't have a preference. Whatever makes a woman feel good about herself, this, that, and the other. A wig is a quick take off, and you know what I mean.
Not always. Not the new lace one. Cause that's glued down.
Well, yeah. Well, as a man, you have to get used to the thing about having the wig is you have to get used to what mama look like under the wig when she takes it off. So you can't get bedazzled by, you know,
yes, you can.
What she is 9 to 5.
Listen, most likely, if a woman is wearing a wig, she has hair. It's a protective style. You know, so they can come and go as they please, and they don't have to really focus that much on their hair. So that's why a lot of times you get weaves or wigs. But she has hair. She probably wears her hair more natural in the summertime if she going to a beach or get some braids or something like that. But most likely...
So why Jada ain't have a wig on?
Because she went bald and she's owning her baldness.
Oh, okay.
I mean, some women...
If you went bald, would you wear... Well, you crossed that path.
You know I've been bald before.
She's been bald before.
I have been bald before. Like, bald.
Because
no
you
hair.
Chose to, not
I chose well, to. Well, I was depression, too, so.
Yeah, but, so I can't even ask you that question. Would you wear
I
wigs?
I wore wigs.
Oh,
I wore wigs when I was bald.
I don't remember.
Yeah, you did. Because remember when I first moved, it came in.
Oh,
had,
yeah, I shot that joint. It fell off and ran.
Fuck you. No, when I sat there, it had the pink. To the side.
That was
shade.
A wig?
That was weave.
Right.
And then the next week I had the long hair.
Oh, yeah. You were...
I was very versatile with my hair.
The master of disguise.
Yeah. I could be anything you want, baby. In the bedroom.
Oh, God.
Let me stop.
Please.
Let me stop talking my mess.
This girl.
But,
if you ever hit the number, I can't even imagine... With
the
your,
shit talking?
No, the bedroom. You probably would have.
I would have a sex dungeon.
A sliding door.
Red room.
Yeah, you probably would.
I would have a red room, toys all locked up, chains.
Hopefully,
shackles.
A sterilization chamber.
Of course. And then I just gotta find my king.
Mm hmm.
Just gotta find my king. That's gonna get some kink. Anyway, when I'm. Now, this is a good question. When you're getting busy,
mm-hmm.
Should a man touch the weave or wig?
Hmm.
I feel like only braids. and locks. Listen, I feel like braids, you could get a good grab.
You cannot.
A wig, you may fuck the lace.
In the moment of passion, you can't control
what's going on. Women tie their
hair. What a woman will want. Now, okay, since you said that, I'm going to bring something into the equation. You cannot come to the bedroom with that Harriet Tubman bonnet on, expect not to get knocked off like one of them 60, like one of them 70 protest late women.
That's not true.
Why are you wearing a bonnet?
What is wrong with a bonnet? I'm protecting my hair.
No.
I'm protecting my hair.
No.
So no bonnet? So if you see a chick with a bonnet on, you ain't fucking her?
No bonnet.
That's bullshit. I see plenty of amateur porn.
No, but
and she wearing a bonnet.
Switch the channel. I'm turning the channel.
And he loving it.
No.
He like McDonald's. Again. Da 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 da. I'm loving it.
They're paid people.
This is like this is like ex boyfriends recording her.
Oh Lord.
You know, like you know, want to get it on and pop, and she's putting a bonnet and all that. I don't think it's, what's wrong with a bonnet. Like, don't get me wrong.
I don't like bonnets.
You don't like bonnets. And some guys don't like. They don't want to see a bonnet either.
A guy who's getting some action ain't gonna tell you he don't like bonnets. I'm keeping it a bean, fellas. We don't like bonnets.
Then you gonna bitch, but we ain't got no edges.
We know you ain't got no edges.
No, we have edges. If we don't wear the bonnet, we are not gonna have any edges.
Oh my God, we don't.
Whatever. Care. Anywho, like point blank, period. Bonnet. Nah. You ain't worrying about no damn bonnet if she giving you a chewy.
Yes, we are.
You wanna run your hands through
it's
her
gonna head? Slide off. Them bonnets slippery as shit.
They are slippery as shit. They are slippery as shit. My jaw will be coming off.
See what I mean?
In my sleep. I'll be like, damn, where the fuck is my bonnet?
The bonnet be down by your toes in the morning. You're like, how the hell did the bonnet get down
I'm
here?
Like, where the fuck is my
they
bonnet?
They serve no purpose.
They do. It's they the third serve, one you gotta get.
Don't come to the supermarket with the bonnet.
The only thing I don't like with the bonnet, like the newer ones now got the elastic band joint. So you take that joint on, then you got the mark on your forehead.
Well, that's because you got headquarters up there, right? You wear a size 8 hat.
I know, you gotta get like an extra large.
Yeah, come on.
I have so many bonnets. It's crazy. But I have one favorite one, and I can't find it right now. It's somewhere.
It's probably in the sheet somewhere.
Probably behind the bed.
Slippery behind bonnet. Anyway, I don't have a preference on weave or wigs. If I had to choose one for the rest of life, I probably would say a weave.
But what about natural?
Again, whatever makes a woman
happy.
Listen,
I think if you're a woman, especially if you're a black woman, woman of color, love your natural hair. Like, I know, like, so many people, like, my youngest niece, I feel like she's self-conscious about her hair because she's young and her hair is not as long.
My daughter's like that, of self-conscious, but she has a very, very pretty face. And we try to tell her that she probably will be snatching them up more with her natural hair.
Yeah.
Her short hair.
Is that the one with the wears the wigs? Or just the other one?
Please don't say wigs. She don't wear wigs. She wears lace fronts and
What's the little wig? A lace wig. It's a lace front wig.
I guess.
Lace frontal. But that's the one that you talking about?
I've
been natural for a long, like, I grew my hair out from, like, being, like, when I cut it off, I grew it out and boom, I decided to get locks within a year. I've been debating getting it for a long time, and I love it.
Okay.
To get up and go. Because as you get older, you don't feel like fucking doing your hair. You really don't.
When like I was them younger, curling iron, them straight iron.
You know how many times I burnt my ear?
Mm-hmm.
Bumping it? That shit sizzles.
That's how they came up with pork rinds. People burning this.
Then your house smelling everything. You smell like, you could definitely smell a woman that just bumped her hair.
Yes.
You can smell it.
Yes.
You can definitely smell it.
Who's cooking bacon? That stuff be sizzling.
Sorry, we had technical difficulties.
Yeah, we're back. And you will be sitting in the bathroom soon. Come on.
Natural hair is, it's a new movement now. You know, rocking natural hair. Like I tell my little niece, hey, your curls are beautiful. I would wish you would lock her hair, you know, and I told her it would grow more. You know, I told her mother that. She don't think she would like it, but I think she would love it. If it's consistent, you know, because you do gotta go like every 3 to 4 weeks to get it retwisted and everything like that. But I love my locks. They looking rough now because of my trip. But wait till you see me later. You know what I'm saying? Get my herds in.
When you go underwater, do it. Well, that's salt water, so that's a different type of water.
I had a lot of sand in my hair.
Oh, yeah.
I had to take like my twisties out.
Right.
Because the back already came out, but the front was good. And then you see most of my charms fell out anyway. But I got more charms. But yeah, it was looking curly and sexy in the water. Because I'm still in the new, but it's still new locking stage where it's still kind of curly. It's not looking like a lock yet. So it's going to take about a good month for my hair to lock. But, you know, I try to keep it up. Keep it up. You know, because I'm still looking for my king and I can't be out here rough. So, next topic.
Yeah, who's up?
It's me. I think you picked that one.
Eden. Yeah, my nephew. I should see him before. He's good. He a nice little boy. I like little chunky boys.
Yeah.
Pause. That sounded hard. That didn't sound right. We had to edit that one. Hopefully y'all didn't hear what I just said.
He was just talking about my nephew.
Yeah, okay.
you know, he want to meet my nephew.
I don't want nobody protesting right now. No,
he's like, you get canceled, bro. I come on next week episode be like, so L was no longer with
us. Right, we had to let him go.
It's just be this podcast.
Yeah, we had to let him go. He is on time right now.
That's not funny.
That didn't come out right
at all.
It
didn't come out right at all. He's had to pause himself.
Yeah.
Because I didn't catch that arrow.
I recorded myself like, did I just say that? Like,
did I just say that? I want a good one.
Yeah.
A good juicy one.
Yeah, we ain't had nothing. What is that for?
Maybe I should pick it. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Okay. What do you prefer? Drunk sex or high sex? I prefer high sex. Bam, that's hands down. I don't know why. You feel thrust. It's crazy. And
just... Oh, my God.
I prefer high sex any day of the week. Drunk sex can be a little like... You can pass out. You just pass out drunk.
Okay. So, I guess my assessment is this. Drunk sex. You mess around and make some babies off of some drunk sex. Because you don't even know what you be doing sometimes.
You talking about blackout drunk?
No, I'm talking about from a guy perspective. Because, you know... Certain alcohols will make you feel like you're Superman. You'll be hanging in there a long time. And then when, you know what I mean?
You don't think we do that?
When that rocket ship. Oh, what? No, well, here's what I'm saying. Uh-huh. So, on high sex, your mind, the everything about it becomes, like, enhanced. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't think drunk sex is you just trying to get through it. Like, oh, you in that mood. I don't want to start making sounds, but you know, you're in that mood and you're like just trying to get that off.
You're actually sweaty though.
But high sex is like you actually enjoying the ride. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, here's the difference real quick. So high sex is like you enjoying the ride and you know, you just going, but drunk sex, it's like you just trying to wait for the ride to be over. Like you trying to, no, seriously, you like, you know, you don't want it to end when on high sex.
No, you don't want it.
You
to
don't
end.
Want it to end because you be like, man, this is.
And
just...
it could be a little painful, but you still be like, keep going.
And I'll say this too: high sex, it might only be 5 minutes, but it feel like the 5 hours. But drunk sex. I don't know. I don't think it's too many rounds after drunk sex. Well, especially for a guy, because you know, drunk, You eat your limbo, you shaking up that beer, that Hennessy and that liquor. Your socks is twisted upside down. You know what I mean?
Or you gotta take them off for a good grip.
That's what I'm saying. You slide in the sock, and then twist it over.
Why did
you always looking for something to hold to kind of, you know, keep your balance?
Why did you just keep their socks on during this?
I don't know, because we don't...
Yeah, weird about y'all feet.
No, what is that? We don't want that roots sex with no shoes on. What the fuck is that? Back to Africa, roots. like, you a slave man.
Yeah, but if you got, like, slippery floors, he had them, like, snatching them. That's what I'm saying. He got to get postured.
Right, so that's why you want to have boys, keep your boots on. You want to have girls, do it with your socks on, because you'll be sliding all over the place. That's my rule.
Okay. Well, I feel like with me, when it comes to high sex, I feel like I get, well, for me personally, I get a little tone deaf.
Almost made me spit on the mic. You lose your hearing?
I know. I get like, I don't lose my hearing, but I don't know how loud I'm being. And I've been told like I'm very loud when I'm high. Like, not even, I'm not talking about just during sex. It's just like conversation period. Like yeah, hey, you know, because I sound like I'm low.
Yeah.
But I'm right, you know. Yeah, in the bedroom, you know. I feel like when a girl is high on and she's about to have sex, she going to be a little nastier. She going to say some shit. She going to talk some shit. Mm-hmm. It's because she's high as fuck. Don't take that shit seriously.
But it'd be some real talk though. But
you real talk.
But the drunk chick wanna be the man. come on, you ain't get over here, right there, move down. You know what I mean? You become more demanding. But the high woman is just kind of just letting you go ahead. You know what I mean?
No, but she's still gonna talk shit.
Yeah, but it's nicely though. It's like, go ahead in the third gear.
No, it's not
that.
I don't know what. No.
Put it in neutral.
I'm where I want to tip. Like, you ain't doing shit, nigga. Like.
See, she want to just get slapped and stuff. And, you know, she want abusive.
No, I don't want abusive. She want abusive. Like, you ain't doing shit.
And when he pick up that brick, and it's that. No, he can't be telling no guy.
Like, harder. Shit. Fuck! Mm-mm. No, I'm just messing.
She's playing. I don't want to see her unconscious in the ER.
I'm not
going to
be unconscious.
Like, what happened? Yeah, I tried to fulfill one of those.
No, but I am tone deaf. So sometimes, like, you know, I guess I could get a little porn starry. And loud. And I don't know how loud I'm being. And I'd be like, what's so loud? They were like, fuck yeah, you were loud. Like, oh shit. Mm. No, my bad.
But what about on the alcohol?
I don't really recall having sex drunk.
You seem like you would be, you're not a drinker, so you
I'm
seem
not a
like
drinker.
You would go to sleep. That would make you,
I would
afterwards,
definitely go to sleep.
You would leave that guy sitting there with a loaded gun after you got yours and be. Now he walking around with a rifle with two shells in it.
I would definitely like be like, all right, I'm going to bed.
See? No.
I'm going to bed. No, but I'll make up for it in the morning.
Man, who? You know,
I love morning sex. Morning sex is the best. I don't know why you say morning sex is the best. So, I mean, you know, I give you some goodies in the morning.
Now he's sleepy.
He's sleepy in the morning?
No, he's a double loaded gun. In the morning.
Well, then that's when you wake him up with a chili.
Now, word from our sponsors.
You wake him up with a chili.
Okay, chili, okay. Yeah. I got you.
Yeah.
I don't know. If I had to roll the dice, I would probably say.
But I'm saying, like, really, when I talk like this, I don't want really anyone to look at me and be
yes,
like.
Yes, please don't, man.
She's like, damn.
Weirdos, don't be.
She kinky, she freaky, like, what the fuck? Yeah, okay. No, yeah. I am talking about if I have a fucking man. I'm not doing all this shit with every fucking body I meet. Mm-hmm. If you the my king, if you're my king, mm-hmm. and you're mine and mine only, mm-hmm. you can get all that treatment for real, like hands down. But not if you just a sneaky link or a hookup. You're not getting all
so,
that.
So, sneaky link gets shortchanged pretty much.
They do.
So they're just being used for that.
How
purpose.
They getting used? They getting off. Oh, man. They getting they get something out of it.
That's part time hours.
Well, I mean it's only part time.
Okay.
You come over. We talk, we chill, we smoke, mm-hmm. we get to business, and you leave.
Then leave. Okay.
If you my dude, you staying. Like what the fuck?
Got you.
You know, but like I said, you gotta have that title, and if I ain't give you that fucking title, then
so you don't, you can't be authority on drunk sex.
I really can't because I never really had drunk sex. I always had high sex. Remember one time you told me to stop?
Yes.
You told me to stop having high sex because you was like, that's just making.
It's a lot of capping involved because I ain't gonna say capping, but your the journey that your mind is on. Mm-hmm. Is not what an after work type of mindset is. Mm-hmm, okay. Getting high sex is just like both of y'all is just on two black. Like what's that movie with Dave Chappelle where the dog was floating?
What movie?
Come on, man! It's a classic. Half Baked.
Oh, I never watched
that. Oh my God, Tosh, you gotta
I'm not
watch
a big
that. You gotta watch
it. No, it looks corny. It looks real corny.
It's not corny.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's just, I don't know, how sex, I just feel like it lasts longer. And it's mental. It's not just mental, though. The sensations are heightened.
Yes, I agree.
So, and I feel like also, too, because I know people that I've talked to in the past, I'm not going to put them on a blast. But, with, like, some women can't take it when they sober or drunk. When they high, they feel like they could take it a little bit more. Like they're more open to taking it. And
alcohol does not control the diameter.
Not alcohol. We talking about weed.
Either one.
Well, I've had people that told me they're like, I can't take it when I'm sober.
Right. No, it may desensitize certain things.
Okay, well, that's probably what it did.
But not, you know, so much whether you can take it versus not taking it.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, even with me, I feel like I could handle things a lot better when I'm high than sober. And then, honestly, it could be bad sex, but... If
see,
I'm
that's
high,
what I mean. It could be, as you say, trash.
It could be trash.
But when you, you know what I mean?
I mean, you can still tell trash, though.
I guess.
You can still tell. I mean, because, I mean, guys have it, too, for women if it's trash.
I don't know if I had too much trash in my lifetime.
Lucky you. I had a lot of trash.
Yeah, I had too much trash.
Like, I mean, honestly, when I look at my, when I have my number, I'm literally deducting, like a lot. But I feel like if I don't remember you, mm-hmm. then most likely it was memorable.
Right.
Especially like a name. Mm-hmm. Like if I'm starting to describe you, old bull with the baseball cap. Or a dude with the headphones.
Right.
With a bow-legged one. You know, shit like the bow-legged
bull
one.
With the ball spot.
Bull with the ball spot. Bull with the cock eyes. Mm-hmm. The guy that came with the cane.
Damn, the bull rolled in with the wheelchair.
No wheelchairs. Stop. Over here. Come on. It was one dude that didn't want to fuck me in the wheelchair. He had, like, the rocker drawing.
Oh, shit.
And he was like, you know, this.
He had rims on it?
No, he had, like, it's like this for disabled.
I know what you're talking about.
But I was like, I didn't like how it looked.
He would have rocked your world, too.
He was packing.
I don't, okay.
He was definitely packing.
Okay.
He was packing.
Anyway, moving right along.
He was packing.
I think we established in our realm how we feel about it. It's probably, I'm going to give two thumbs up for high sex over drunk sex.
Yes.
Drunk sex.
I'll tell you. Like a 10.
Now, this is the plus in drunk sex. Afterwards, it's the best sleep.
Yeah, it's the best sleep drunk, probably.
Now, high sex, you don't get a good night's sleep because your mind is so popping that you want to run that back. No, you can't sleep. You're trying to get an encore in the morning. So you're like, damn, that joint was right. This, that, and the other. So
you won't get an encore regardless in the morning if he stay.
Well.
You can get an encore anyway in the morning.
Anyway, what's the next, what's the next topic there?
Your turn.
Oh, okay.
Your turn. Your turn.
I don't hear that no more.
The love don't
I don't hear that no more.
Your turn. I don't want to tie my phone.
Shut up.
Well, I'm not getting anything either. So what the fuck?
All right.
How do you think I feel? I'm really stressed.
You ain't stressed.
I am stressed. I need a release. But I just don't want anybody. Because I found out one of my stalkers yesterday.
Oh, my God.
Found out one of my stalkers. He'll probably see this messaging me. Can I get your new number? I'm like, who the fuck is this? Can I change my number? Yeah.
He's a fan, though. Let that boy live.
He is a fan, but he's on some shit like, I miss you.
He's being honest. He did.
I don't think he misses me.
So he just wasting time, huh?
I don't know what... The boy's lonely, and he need to...
And you're not?
I'm not that lonely.
Oh, my God. Stop.
I ain't that lonely.
Stop.
I got Bob, okay?
Bob...
I don't want that.
Bob is... Don't...
I don't want that. I am not that lonely.
If you think you're lonely,
wait until the night goes.
All right, I think I got this one. Regrets. Is that the third one?
Yeah, that's the third one.
Regrets.
You can go first.
Okay, what does... What in your definition, what does regret mean? Something you look did. You going to talk about it while I look it up? Well, you can look it up. Oh, you can't. Oh.
I can't
look it up. Regrets. Go ahead, Tash.
I feel like people shouldn't have regrets. You have to look at as regrets as a lesson to me. I wouldn't see it as a regret. You just see it as a lesson. Mm-hmm. Like, hey... You know, you may at the beginning be like, damn, I regret buying that dress.
Mm-hmm.
And it fucked my money up. But in all honesty, okay, you got the dress. You can't do the shoulda, coulda, woulda anymore. You just gonna have to own up to it and be like, damn, I know not to do that again. You know, I learned my lesson.
Mm-hmm.
So what we got?
I can't read that. My eyes
are Feel sad. Repent or disappoint over something that has happened or been done, especially a loss or missing opportunity.
Right.
So. Really feeling, you feeling sad though? Like.
Well, you can, yeah, you.
I mean, you, it does
you
make you
can feel
fun.
Sad.
You can feel sad.
You can, a regret could be something like you said something that you, that hurt someone's feelings, and mm-hmm. you did not mean it to stick like that.
Like that, okay.
You know what I mean? Like, you could tell somebody, or the other side is you can regret to tell somebody something like, you know, don't play with matches. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And now they're sitting outside while the fire department there. So regrets has a lot of different angles that you can take.
Yeah.
On something, but the definition kind of says it all. It's something that, man, that you feel sorrowful for, or you have sadness about. Because you can be, you know, I can.
I guess. I mean, yeah. I definitely have some
regrets. You have some regrets.
Everybody has regrets.
You
but
might have a regret not going to college.
I do. I regret not going to college. I regret dropping out of high school. And, you know, I regret a lot of things. I regret, like, buying all the clothes here for my trip.
Right.
You know, that was a regret. I regret dating the last guy I dated.
I don't think you regret that.
I do regret that.
No, you might regret the outcome of dating him. I don't think you regretted it at the time.
No, at the time, no. But the outcome, the way it went, it was fucked up. So
yeah,
point blank, period. Like, but now I'm not even like making it a regret anymore. Mm-hmm. It's a lesson.
A lesson.
It was a lesson.
So it's not a regret. It was a lesson because
But that's why I said you got to learn from your regrets.
Right, yeah.
You know, you got to be more cautious now on who you bring in your world. You cannot just invite anyone in. Mm-hmm. And like I said, it was a lesson learned. It is what it is. You move on with it.
Right.
You know, like I regret moving here. Right. I definitely regret it. Right. Like, because I'm living on top of my mom, and that was not the plan. They were supposed to move out when I moved in, and it fell through for them.
Mm-hmm.
So my mom's stuck here. She's not old enough for it. She's stuck because she's not old enough for a senior place.
Right. Well, I don't think she's
only 61, so she gotta wait till like 65.
There's opportunities out there.
She had opportunities and she fucked those up. So,
So then she may have some regrets.
I don't know what regrets my mom has. I don't really care to ask, but
right.
I know for me, like I regret a lot of things. You know, I'm not even gonna lie to you. Sometimes I regret
not having children.
No,
you don't.
Okay. Because I had a plan.
Oh, okay.
Like I told you, I didn't ever want to be a baby mom.
Well, just because you had children, that doesn't definitely mean that you're going to be a baby mom.
I'm not judging anyone that is a baby mom and not married and all that stuff.
Right.
It's just something, me growing up in such a broken household, I didn't want that for my child.
Right.
I wanted the father to be involved, so I wanted to be married.
Right.
To share that experience with my husband or whatever. But since that has not happened.
There's no guarantees with marriage either.
I'm fine with that. Huh? Like, I mean, die old maid. I mean.
You ain't going to die no damn old
I'm
maid.
I'm an old maid already.
You got nieces and nephews. You ain't going
to
die.
They are not my kids.
So, you know, that's not going to make you an old maid.
And I don't see them like that. So, you know, it's different when you have your own kids. It's different when
you want some.
I don't want none.
No, I mean,
I don't.
You can borrow mine. That's what I mean.
I thought you was going to donate.
No. No.
I really don't want no kids. Like, I prefer, like, right now, if I meet, I have to either meet a guy. Shut up. I have to meet a guy who either don't want kids, like I don't want kids.
Right.
Or I have to meet a guy who already has kids and he doesn't want anymore.
Right.
I mean, I had somebody tell me, like, I was talking a lot. She was like, yeah, what if you meet the right one?
Right.
And they want kids. I'm like, I feel like I'm too old.
You're never too old, man.
I have PCOS.
You made that clear at one point about that.
The PCOS is very difficult. And then I'm considered morbidly obese. So it's difficult. My mom was a big woman and she had three kids.
Don't let nobody give you no title. That says that you can't.
Well, I mean, I just wouldn't even want to go.
Won't you do
that.
It?
That won't pain. Like,
come on. You know what? This is what kills me.
That pain.
When I hear you talk about that pain, that's like when I go to
your epidural and your spine. And
Put your arm up.
Put my arm up.
Let me see your hand. The other hand. Put it down. Pain.
That's not pain.
That tattoo on your arm was pain.
Yeah.
Okay. So
yes, but this isn't a needle in your fucking spine.
I don't want to
hear
about
pain. This
isn't your
vagina stretching the fuck open for a human life to come out.
It's built that way.
I don't want my shit that way.
It's built that way.
I don't want my shit that way. Or then sometimes you may have to get a C-section. And then that's an issue.
That thing... is built that way.
Well, I don't, Elvis, it's not some in the cards for
you
me.
Know you be watching the Fiston videos, you, it's built that way.
I didn't say that.
I didn't say that either. I never did I say that? Well, you guilty though, because it's written out over here. Why'd you get excited and smiling when even when I go like this? As I was saying, oh my God. The woman anatomy is built to stretch that way.
Why?
And I'm going to say that for all you guys that think because, you know what I mean?
What the fuck?
You just really ain't doing nothing. You still throwing the hot dog down the hallway. Okay?
Well, who?
Who? I don't know. I'm just talking.
Listen, I'm...
Y'all built for it. So I'm not trying to hear that. You see some of the heads on some of these kids? Are you kidding? Don't you care? Don't you say that about your nephew. Leave him alone. Leave him alone.
She went natural.
Leave him. So, there you go.
Good. That's built for that shit.
Y'all built for that shit.
Y'all built for that shit.
I ain't built for that shit.
I ain't built for that shit. But I'm going to be a bitch on Labor Day. I'll be like, you did this to me. You motherfucker.
You don't want to be nasty to them doctors in there.
I'm talking about my husband. I'll be like.
What if it's not a husband?
I'm like, I don't want a baby dad.
You might not know who your baby dad too.
No, because I feel like baby dads walk away. They walk. And it's a little harder for a husband to walk away. You know, you said it yourself.
You can't walk away.
You can.
I shouldn't even say a husband. A real man. What? That's his seat. That's his.
Yeah, but you got a lot of motherfuckers out here that don't give a fuck about their seat.
That's terrible.
It is terrible.
That's terrible.
It's really fucked up. But you got a lot of motherfuckers out here that
and
will
then they
walk
have
away.
That another man come and, you know what I mean, and help raise their kids. And some of them dudes never be like, you know what, I wasn't there. You know, thank you for being what entity that you were. And my child's life is that. And the other.
I give it to a man that can come in and take care of somebody else's kid. I give it to that person because it's like, that's not even your responsibility and you taking it on.
Right. So, listen, baby dads.
I just don't. I never wanted to be. I feel like that's always been in my family. You know, even though my mom been married twice, she picked shitty men.
But you think she knew? This is like
she had to know. All right. She had to know. Like, if you knew your first husband since he was like 18 years old and he was like in his fucking 30s, like, that's some R. Kelly shit.
But she wasn't anticipating that if she gave him a child that he was going to step in the name of love. She didn't think that.
Like, even my dad, like, she knew my dad was definitely gaslighting her and love bombing her. Like, she had to know, like, he was capping her. My mom knew she was a side chick when it came to my dad.
Oh, my God. See what I mean? This is what I'm talking about.
What?
Why are so many people you know how many people, you were a bus driver at one time. You know how many people were climbing from under the bus? Did you just throw people down there?
I don't give a fuck
about
my podcast.
Like, I agree.
I believe my dad played that role, you know, sweet pillow talk bullshit to my mom. And my mom fell for the dream, and it did not occur the way she wanted it.
Right.
And she was bitter about it for a long fucking time. And I had to deal with that.
I believe strong women come, even though it's probably not a good thing, sometimes strong women are mean. From baby mamas. You look at, and I can give you a list of Shaq's mom.
Yeah, if you are a woman
Iverson's
that can be
mom,
a, I know, don't I get just, me wrong, I could be a single mother.
Okay, so then
I just don't want to be.
Why?
Why should I have to take up all that responsibility myself? I wasn't the only one that laid down.
It don't make
person.
You less than a woman, though.
It doesn't make you less than a woman. I respect any single mother out there.
Right.
Especially if you got multiple kids and you single by yourself doing it, working, yeah. Taking care of all your kids.
Going to
you got
daycare,
that. Going to school. And all
then
that.
Going to school. Yeah,
yeah.
So come on.
So I give it to you. It's just
some
like
of the greatest woman
that's
in the
just
world.
Something I never wanted.
Because
that's all I've seen growing up. I wanted to see healthy relationships. Like, I know my cousin Toy and James, they're married.
There we go, under the bus.
That's not the one under the
examples.
Bus. They're married. On my dad's side, you got my grandparents. You got
how long they been together?
Over 6 years.
Six?
60.
Oh, God bless them.
Over 6 years. And you got my cousin Nene and her husband Ron. They're married. Like, everyone else is just like common law.
His wife, Denzel and his wife been together.
Yeah, well, I'm talking about, I was just talking about like when it comes to my family. Like my dad is 61, single, still not married. Lord. You know, like I just didn't want that.
Right. Okay.
For me. That was never my choice. And I ain't gonna lie, when I was younger, I did want the white picket fence and the perfect kind of life. Because I didn't have that growing up. But I don't really, I wouldn't live in Philly. Fuck. But now as I'm older, I'm like, listen, I just want someone to share my life with. We could travel, we could do stuff with it. If he has kids, I will learn to love his kids. But my thing is, like, I don't want any of my own. It would have to take some convincing. It would be that drunk night, right? Yeah, right. It'll be that one drunk night.
Right. So, as you were saying, so you don't want to be a baby's mama.
No.
But you'll take on a man's children.
I mean, the mother's still involved.
And still deal with baby mama drama.
But we don't, no, it would not
deal with that. See, that's what I'm talking about. No,
she has to be like, want to meet her, because if I'm around her children, she would want to meet me.
I would hope so.
And I'm hoping she's not some chick that's still hung up on her baby dad. Right. You know, like, because I feel like this baby dads and baby moms, no matter whether they're together or not, they always can get it.
Why is that out there? That's not true.
I feel like they always get some. Like, I'm not going. I would never fuck my baby dad again. But then you never know. He come over one day. He may bought some fucking Popeye's chicken.
Oh and my god!
And you probably, it's been a minute. And you be like, he looking kind of good right now. I'm not saying every woman do that, but
right.
What I'm just saying, like. I mean, I just never wanted to be nobody, baby mama.
I respect that. I mean, but again, nobody signs up.
I know my worth to the point where I feel like a ring should be on my finger.
Right.
You know, if you want me to be the mother of your children, you should marry me.
Right.
So, if I'm not good enough to be a wife, why am I good enough to be the mother of your child?
All right.
That's just my theory. You know, from my point of view, some people are fine with that. That's not me. Mm-hmm. Because you could be with someone, had a baby, and you waiting for that ring.
Right.
And you could be waiting 2, 3.
Sometimes it happens that
4,
way.
4, 5. I mean, I had a cousin who just got married last November. She's been with her dude like over 20-something years. They got 2 kids together and stuff like that. They just got married.
But can I say something about that? So, I know it's cliche when people say, if it ain't broke, then don't fix it.
Mm-hmm.
So you could be married, unmarried with somebody for years, and then eventually get married. They live under the same roof all the time, though?
No. They have not. She, at one point, she was living with her mother, and he was...
You really never know somebody till you live with them.
Well, they've lived with each other for the past, like, 5 years.
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. Sometimes when the relationship works when you're not married. And then when you get married, the relationship, because each party, and you go, this all will go back to what we talk about, people not having honest conversations. And then you get married, and then his perception of what he thinks is going, are we married? So now we're going to upgrade to this. And her perception is, okay, now we're married. We're going to get a joint bank account. All the bills are
going
to be
50-50. I mean, that probably was already going
on. But those things never get discussed. That's why
I feel like with their relationship, I think the thing that took so long for him to finally ask her to marry him and for them to get married is, I think he kept saying something like, you know, he wanted to make sure the ducks was in a row financially.
No, that never lines up. So let me ask you this. How about this? Okay, do they have... I don't want to say
children. Together.
Do they have children outside the marriage?
Yes, he does.
See, those are it's a lot of. So.
Well, I just feel like maybe he wasn't ready. I mean, of course, it's been times when they broke up and he probably went out and did something and then his other kids. And there's no judgment there. But they love each other. They're married now. They're happily married. But I don't want to be 20 years waiting for that day.
Okay.
That's me. I'd rather.
So how long would you want to be dating before? before you think.
Well, I used to have a time frame. I don't have a time frame no more. Since I said the kids is out the window, like, for me.
So Prince Charming just walked in through the door and was like, please don't do that, little if Prince Charming, whoever that may be, walked through the door, would you be willing to marry?
Right away?
Yeah.
Hell no.
So what time frame would you think that you...
I think 2 years.
Okay.
I think you would
date for 2 years?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would date for 2 years, exclusively.
Then get engaged.
I would say we...
How long would you stay engaged?
A year.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A year.
So that's 3 years.
3 years.
Okay.
I mean, like the first year you dating, and then maybe the second year y'all live together. Mm-hmm. So, because you gotta see if you can fucking sleep with them. Mm-hmm. I feel like you should see that before you fucking marry them. You don't want to wait till you get married to see if I can live with them.
Well, that's the right way to be married.
That's not.
No, biblically, that's the right way.
What? To be. You're supposed to get married and then live with them. You're not supposed to be living with them.
Because you know
together.
When you're living together, there's things that you're doing you ain't supposed to be doing.
You doing that. And nobody's waiting 3 years to
yes.
fuck. No, who's waiting 3 years to fuck?
None.
They wait a lifetime. What the?
There's some chicks out here that wait.
Well, I mean, I give it to Sierra and Russell Wilson. She waited like a year.
But she already had kids.
She had a son, but when she met her wasn't having sex.
Right.
They were just dating, and like with after a year of them together, he proposed.
Mm-hmm.
And they got married.
That's why he not throwing touchdowns like he used to.
I mean, same thing with Megan Good and her old husband. They weren't having sex either.
Is he a pastor?
He is a pastor, but they're going through a divorce now. So.
See?
But, I mean, I don't have a problem with it. Like, I don't need a bad boy. I don't need, like, a rough kind of guy.
You want a bad boy, though.
I don't want a bad boy. I want a bad boy in the bedroom.
You
but know, I want a sweet guy. Bad boys, I feel like you can't take home.
Why not?
To introduce to your family. Like, to me, I'm not a person. I just take anybody to meet my family. I don't.
I wonder if I consider a bad boy. Am I considered a bad boy?
I think you are a kind of guy somebody would want to take home to meet mom and dad.
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely that guy.
You know, like me,
I'm charming. I'm very charming.
Like, my family know how I am. I'm real picky in particular. Like, I've been with a lot of guys in the past.
Mm-hmm.
But it's only certain ones that have met my family.
Right.
That mm-hmm. I saw potential in. But, you know... You just can't bring everybody
right
to meet your family. I think yeah, I did that one time when I was younger, and he kind of showed his ass, and my grandma did not like him.
Oh, my God.
My grandma was like, I don't know. He's
my daughters used to be scared, too. We had a couple incidents.
Because y'all want to be judged.
Bring boys.
I'm not even going to lie. This is to be me being honest.
I asked them, can you count it? I asked them what their goals. When my daughters bring guys, I asked the guys what their goals is, stuff like that. One guy said he didn't like school. I told her he needed to let him go. If he don't like school. Then
yeah, he gotta go.
He got baby mama.
He do
all written. I'm saying he got you gonna be a baby mama written all over his face when he said he don't like school.
Yeah, it's like me. Like when I was dating Robert, I was very proud because we were talking about marriage. And like
you need to stop talking about marriage in your relationships, girl.
What? I feel like you need to let that be known what you want.
Well, true.
Off the bat, because if you don't want that, then don't waste my time. That's how I feel. But my thing is, like I said, I'm not trying to rush it either. Damn, mm-hmm. I said 3 years. The fuck? Like, you know. But I'm saying when we were talking about marriage and we were young. We were like 20, 21, 22. Mm-hmm. And we actually merged families together at my house, at my dad's house. Mm-hmm. His family came and my family was there. And I was really excited because it was like I wanted the families to get along.
Right.
Because if we were talking to spend the rest of our life, we was going to spend a lot of time with the families and stuff. But it didn't work out. You know, we wanted different things. You know, I hope he's doing... he could be married with some kids by now. No, he was in school to be an architect, so...
Mm.
He could be doing his thing. Shout out to Rob, wherever you at. Even though you left me on the side of the road, motherfucker. Shit.
Shout out to Rob. You got a way, man. Way good.
Yeah, you got a way, because we was definitely not compatible. He was a Taurus. It was not a Libra and a Taurus. No, I'm surprised we lasted as long as we did. Now, the last situation that I brought home to my family, I was actually proud of that.
Very proud. Who was the sign?
What?
Zodiac.
Who?
Your last situation you brought home.
Fucking Scorpio. I know.
Yeah.
But I was proud of it.
Right.
Very proud.
Right.
I was
proud.
I'm not talking about it no more. But I'm just saying, like, I was very proud of that. But it wasn't like I was rushing any kind of future either. Oh, do you think I was?
No, I didn't say nothing.
You looked at me funny, dog.
I looked at you. That's all.
You looked at me funny.
No, I just happened to look at you. That's all.
So you think I rush things?
No, I don't. Listen.
Just don't. I mean,
you want what you want.
I'm a woman of a certain age.
Yes, you want what you want.
I want what I want, and I feel like
you are eliminating the game. You were really kind of trying to eliminate. If it was not going that direction, then maybe you need to stop.
If you want different things in the person, then that's fine.
The problem was you was only supposed to put a toe in. And you went all the way up to the side.
And then I would take responsibility for that.
Right. Yeah, that's
and
all.
That was all me.
That's all. But, you know, we learn from, you know, situations
like
that.
I do know, like, the next time when I do get into another situation, like, I really got to get to know the person.
Right. You know what I mean?
Fucking confuses me. Because, like, I know what you say, but I feel like if that was the case, they should have went skedaddle after that one. That's just my theory.
It doesn't work that way.
It does. Okay.
That's the way you want it to work.
No, I didn't want it to work like that. I didn't, but I did have that mindset, like, I ain't never going to see that motherfucker again. Oh, well, so be it. You know, that's just like, oh, well. But then you kept coming the fuck around. It was like, what was the point?
Right.
You know, what was the point? But at the end of the day, I'm not even, like, dwelling on it anymore. You know, lesson learned, baby. Right now, I will tell you this. I'm scared of it.
Mm-hmm.
I never want to kind of feel that feeling again.
Right.
So, like, that's why I'm really standoffish when motherfuckers DM me. That shit pisses me off. Like, leave me the fuck alone. Because if you ain't about nothing, I had one guy say, well, I just want to know when you are ready. Just want to throw my head in. What the fuck that's supposed to mean? I want to throw my head in. Like, can I throw my head in?
He said he
wouldn't. I don't want to lose my spot. Like, what the
Listen, what he's basically saying. Let me dissect what he's saying.
Yeah, but he's not.
So what he's saying is, he's at the lunch meat counter, right? And he has a number. And he just wants to know when is his turn to order his meat.
Never.
That's what he said to me.
I had another one on Instagram, was kind of like, and you know, he I said no. And then he was like, okay, cool, it's not that deep. I was like, all right, fine.
See, you a man basher.
I'm not a man
basher.
But
you know what? You need. Again, what did I tell you the other day? You have a wall up.
Yeah, you said
I'm not
going
to put it out there because I don't want the fake energy.
Say what you said.
No, what I was going to say is that you have a wall up.
I do.
And you're going to know when the right man comes because he's going to willing to climb that wall despite your pushback. If you're pushing back and somebody is hanging on the wall and they drop off, that's a good thing because he's not willing to push beyond your pushback, if you know what I'm saying. Like, a real man, a real G, will sit there and he'll be like, I'm not interested, I'm not bothered. He's not going to be threatened by that because if he really has a general interest in you, he's going to continue to pursue what he wants. So
we will see, because my pushback game is crazy.
And if you continue to scratch like that, you're going to have problems with getting
sunburned. Why are you so... I have sunburn.
I know. I'm just messing with you.
Leave me alone.
I'm just not saying.
No, you. Like, I mean, I feel like that's like the last thing I'm really thinking about. I mean,
I'm
living my life. I'm doing what I gotta do for me. Put me first, you know, mm-hmm. loving on myself, dating me. You know, I'll take me out on some dates.
Right.
Because that's the thing. I don't like with the DM shit and nobody asking for a date. You talked
about the social media.
I understand that, but don't come in.
It's a fishing game.
Yeah, but it's just like you don't come in with the damn sexy, hey beautiful, all that. Say what the fuck you gonna say. Like, say, hey, I want to get to know you. Let's go out. And I'll think about it.
Mm-hmm.
But honestly, I don't even want to do, like, meet people online.
But enjoy the dating, though. Enjoy dating.
I can enjoy the dating. Because I'm telling you, I got my chastity belt is strong, baby.
Man, that shit got Velcro on it.
Fuck you.
They break away drawers.
Fuck that. I don't have to give up any cookies.
Break away drawers.
I'm not going to give up no cookies. Now, if I want to just fuck you, I will just fuck nice, not you.
Oh, I know.
The way you look. Nah, the way you look. If I want to, if I just want to fuck a person, I could fuck you with no feelings.
Okay.
and keep it pushing. Like, for real, for
is
real.
Is that a good way? That's another good thing, Tosh.
Why?
Because you have to value your plantation.
I do value it.
It's more to just want, give women it have away.
Needs. Women have needs too. Like, why do we have to be so proper? So, because oh my God, you can't give your flower
that's
away.
We as
but
men
can sling they wood any fucking where they want.
Because we know we the dirt of the earth, but we value our women as diamonds. And
what
we,
woman? I ain't nobody woman. The fuck?
Well, then you really shouldn't be just.
Listen, I have a past. I'm not always proud of my. I have some regrets from.
Can I say something about when people say that I have a past?
What?
You ready for this?
Go ahead.
Last night was your past. So why do we keep saying we have a past? Everybody got a past.
Yeah, everybody got a past, but some so people, but men act like they're the only ones that have a past. Like women, like I said, my 20s, I did my whole phase. You know, and I'm not trying to do my whole phase now in my 30s.
Mm-hmm.
If I, you know, I only want to be a whole one person. You know what I'm saying? Whoever my king is out there. But my thing is point blank period. You know, I still have fucking needs, and I'm sorry, Bob don't do everything. The fuck? There's nothing wrong with a friend with benefits.
Okay.
You just gotta remember he's a friend.
No, but I could have sworn
what?
Earlier you said that you just don't want to be given.
I don't want to be given it to
anybody,
anyone.
You know what I mean? But then friends with benefits is not a problem. I'm very confused. Right
okay.
Now.
Never mind.
It's just me. I'm just
no,
confused.
It's not just you. It's you and the audience. It's you and the audience. Because now you make it seem like I'm contradicting myself.
Listen.
I'm contradicting myself.
Sit down. We're going to have a little talk. So, when were you born? I'm going to be your therapist right now because you're...
When I was born? October 10th, 1983.
Were you born in a manger or in a hospital?
Hospital.
How many pounds? How many ounces?
8 pounds, 3 ounces.
God damn.
Fuck you.
No, I'm just messing around.
That was small, okay. That's as small as I ever fucking been.
It all started back then.
I was a small baby. Screw you.
That's the problem. See, even she's saying screw at this age. at her age, she's still using the word screw.
Shut up. Go. What's the next question?
When is our next episode of this podcast? Because I ain't got that much goddamn time to be counseling you. Come on, sit up. Come on, we gotta talk.
What? Counseling. I'm good. I'm in a good headspace.
All right, that's good.
I'm in a good mood. Nothing's gonna ruin that.
That's
you know.
Great.
I just know what I want out of life right now, as of now, and if I feel like a person can't give it to me, I'm not wasting my time anymore with anyone.
At the end of the day, you said you got needs, and you're going to do what you're going to do. So,
I mean, I'm torn by it because I say it's scary. It's just scary to
me. It's a very scary situation.
It's a very scary situation. Some people, like, I feel jealous, you know, because I have friends that, I'm not saying no names, I'm just saying I have friends that can do the hookup culture and be good.
They're good outside of the house. Behind closed door, nobody's... I don't know. I don't think anybody's good with just hookups. Because everybody wants to be loved. Everybody wants to have somebody
Well, I feel like some people don't want to be loved.
It's a temporary drug. Hooking up is just a temporary drug. Because you're always looking for that next hookup. So I don't think that anybody's happy with that. Okay?
Maybe. I don't know. I think
men are. Professor Mo. Men are. Oh, you tried to slip that one in. You think men are what? Come on, let's go.
Men love a hookup culture. They like that nostalgia of meeting someone.
And that has nothing to do with...
It do. It really do.
That has everything to do with...
They love that fucking trace. Oh, ego. Man. And then they get her, and then what they do?
What?
What they do? I'm bored.
I'm bored.
Let me chase somebody the fuck out.
It's not that he's bored. That's not.
I'm listening.
Turn your back on me. It's not that he's bored. What happens is he finds out that you're a psycho. Or something like that, and he'd be like, "Whoa!" I'm not talking about you.
I know I'm fucking crazy.
No, man, I found out that, like, yo, and that's why I say, all jokes aside, I'm gonna get serious right now. That's why it's not imperative that you don't give your cookie up too early in a relationship, because a man can find out that it's some things that he didn't like about you, and vice versa, a woman can find out. It's some, I really didn't like him. And y'all have regrets about, like, you know, I gave that piece of crap.
Yeah.
That, my cookie. Fact. So, you know, I get it. Everybody has needs and everybody wants to be loved. But you, it's a tough thing. You know what I mean?
I was looking for love. He was looking for a lay. So that's why I say it was a lesson learned. So I do know if a real man comes in and he is interested, of course, I'm not going to sit there and rush into it.
Okay. I just feel that, and I'm going to shut up after this. I just feel that where you are in your life, you need a man who's together. You don't need a man that's trying to get himself together.
I already know that.
But sometimes you...
But like I said, I got to
supplement your feelings. A woman can't make a man get himself together.
Oh, I know that too.
Honestly, he has to want to have. If he's still living at home with his mama and he's past 28 years old, I think
I'm not even gonna lie. I fell in love with the idea. In the potential I saw. So that's on me.
Right.
I will take that 100%. That was me.
Right.
Okay. So that's where that comes from.
Right.
But it wasn't given what it was supposed to give.
I get it.
It wasn't given, and it wasn't meant to be. It was too vinegar, like oil and water.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't mix. And I understand that.
Right.
I understand that now, and I'm good with it.
This therapy session was sponsored by Allen Associates. Anyone that needs
therapy. I didn't need a therapy session.
Are you interrupting my infomercial? As I was saying, this episode was... I forgot my whole thing. It's sponsored by Allen Associates. For those that need therapy sessions and want to talk about things that's on their mind, I could definitely put you back in the proper retrospect to be a very empowering woman and feel good about yourself. And despite your needs, I can help you.
There you go.
I can't help her.
No, nobody can help me.
You know who I feel
not
like?
Not even my real therapist can write out.
Do you know who I feel like working with this young lady, man?
What? Tell me.
My new name, and if you're a real movie person, you'll understand. My new name is Dr. Loomis, okay?
You know, I'm not that bad. Am I that bad?
You know
am
Dr.
I
that Loomis bad? Is?
Because you feel like you think you feel like women should be submissive.
What?
I really do feel like you.
Why shouldn't a woman be submissive?
Listen,
as a man, I think a man is submissive to a woman. He's going to work every day. He wants to help out with the bills. A man should want to help out with raising the children. This, that, and the other. And he cannot be that strong entity in the home as a woman is. With the children, and that's why he loves his woman and it respects what she does. So why shouldn't a woman be submissive to a man?
Not right off the back.
Well, so what are you going to show him to impress him?
You probably have showed him.
No, what are you going to show a man to impress him? Come on.
I'm not talking about sexually. I'm just saying, like, I have.
Okay, what way are you going to show a man that you're, you know what I mean? Without being submissive. How can you show him that you're going to be that queen on the next level?
Because, obviously, you see, I've been holding down
the... Don't say obviously, because obviously doesn't work.
I've been holding down the fort on my own. This is all me. Everything in here, I pay
get that.
For. Everything I clean, I cook, I do my own shit. No one has helped me.
Mm-hmm.
I can do this on my own.
Right.
Here. So, here. But I could do it any fucking where.
Right.
So, best believe, if you meet a woman like...
So, why wouldn't you want to be submissive, didn't you?
Nobody said if
you're
my husband. You're
talking about what you're doing
you're
for
my
you.
Husband.
You're talking about
if
what
you're my
you
husband.
For...
If you're my husband. But then you got some that want all the fucking control. They want all of it. And I'm sorry, for me to be a woman that's been single for a very long time and stuck in a lot of my ways, I can't give you that. I can't give you that.
Miss Jackson, if you nasty... Didn't she make a song called Control?
She did. Okay. And what she say? When I was 17, I did what people told me. Did what my father said. And let my mother mow me. Uh-huh. But that was long ago. I'm in control. Yeah. Right?
Yeah, that's how the song
goes. That's how the song go.
So let's look at.
But now I'm in control.
Let's look at Janet's life and relationship about control.
Let's look at it.
Enough said.
It's not enough said.
She's not happy.
She's happy now.
With Jermaine, she don't.
She's not with Jermaine.
He dating again.
They ain't cheat on her.
I don't know.
Back in the day, I never. They dating again, really?
Yeah, they dating again.
Didn't he have somebody?
They are dating again.
Damn. Sad, Janet. You don't think she happy? Maybe that. Look at Jennifer Lopez. She got back with Ben. They're getting married again.
I know. What happened to the baseball ball?
Which one?
A-Rod? A-Rod, yeah.
I think he cheated.
Oh, man.
Yeah, and my fucking oh, he cheated. He got caught with some bitches.
Can we take that word out the dictionary?
He got caught with some bitches in Miami. What? Miami. I mean, you got Tristan Thompson. He's like, ugh. You know, but the shit he did to Chloe was kind of fucked up. But he's young. She should have never fucked with him, cause first of all, because he was young. He's not ready. He was never ready. And you out here making other babies with other bitches. Like, you not even wrapping your shit up.
I don't like to talk about people, honestly, but let me ask you this.
What?
Christian took a lot on his shoulders, too.
Christian who?
Tristan?
Yeah. What he took?
Do you know how many industry people that Chloe was with?
And?
He just
got
caught up with
them. Not while she was with him.
I don't know about that.
No, she wasn't fucking with nobody when she was with him.
He took a lot on the chin, Paul.
She really loved him. She really loved him.
I'm not saying that she didn't, but...
And he fucked her over. Not once, but twice. Never, ladies... Don't do sexy chances. Like, fuck it. I feel like once a cheater, always a cheater. That's just my theory. Now, if you have a man that is actually good to you after he fucking cheated. But see, I'm just a bitch. I can't forget that shit. I can forgive you, but I ain't going to forget it. But I'm not going
to So you can't be in a relationship with somebody that ever stepped out on you.
No, I can do that. I'm not a forgiving person.
I'm a forgiving
person.
No, you're not a forgiving person.
There is a forgiving person. I'm forgiving you. For me, because I won't be able to move on and live a happy life if I hold that grudge, right? If I hold that grudge, but that's the truth. Even Steve Harvey had said it. You're not forgiven for that person. You're forgiven for yourself.
Absolutely.
But I'm not. It's gonna run through my mind. But men can't do it either. Because if you forgive a woman that fucking cheats on you, time she go out, you gonna think she's sucking somebody off or she fucking somebody.
You might think that, but if you a real G, if you forgave her, you gonna just sit there, you gonna give her the benefit of the doubt. That's what forgiveness is about. You know that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Forgiveness is about for you giving the person a second chance, the benefit of the doubt. But if you can't close that door on what they did, and you can consistently keep reminding that person.
Listen,
let me tell you something about a man. If a man steps out and he cheated, and you as a woman, you constantly keep bringing it up and reminding him, you're only making the situation better, because if he stepped out with another woman, 9 times out of 10, that woman provided something that he was missing in the situation over here. And if you continuously keep reminding him of the other situation, eventually you say, why am I staying in this situation? Because she keep reminding me of this other situation that I know about. Why do you have to keep telling me about what I did?
First of all, I don't have to remind you. I'm not forgetting, that doesn't mean I'm bringing it the fuck up. If you said you're going out with your boy,
you don't have to bring it up. You'll wear it on your face. You won't have to bring it up. You don't have to say it. You can show it. You can bring it up. Babe, what's for dinner? You want to show it. It's come on, Ty.
Barbecue chicken. And fried rice.
Mm. Okay.
And broccoli.
This is it right here, babe?
I'll make you plate.
Okay. Can I
you this want something to drink?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay,
can you take a sip first?
First of all, I can't accuse you of shit if I don't have fucking proof. I just have to be in my gut saying, all right, if he said he gonna go do this, he gonna go do this.
I don't like your energy when you said, yeah, it's barbecue chicken. You want me to make my plate? Taste this chicken. Fuck out of here.
Fuck you.
See, I think we're gonna end this episode.
She don't want to
taste the drink or eat the chicken.
I'm not killing nobody. Oh, listen, I'm not fighting over no man.
Slow death.
I'm not fighting over no man.
Slow.
If a bitch want them, a bitch can have them. I don't do that.
Yeah, okay, Tosh.
I don't fight over no. I never had to fight for no dude. Never in my life.
Okay. See.
What?
The helicopters. You don't want to taste the drink. They know.
I know for a fact. Like you may think I'm cuckoo for cocos.
No, I never said that.
You do. Because I said I won't forget in my mind. Like I know you fucked around on me before, I won't forget it.
So why I'm not bringing it up. Let him go though.
But I wouldn't even take that second chance. Cause I feel like
so
this.
You never loved me.
For me. Oh wow. It's for me once. For me once. For me twice. Nobody gonna have me looking like Bobo the Clown. Okay.
Never loved him in the beginning.
Wow.
You don't have a forgiving spirit. It's okay.
Wow. Okay. So. Let's say I do some shit like that, right?
If your boss shortchanged your check, do you quit your job?
No.
You go back
because
you forgave him.
That's my job. That pays my fucking bills.
And he's your husband.
He's not my husband.
Your boyfriend.
He's not my boyfriend either.
Forgive him.
I forgave.
Drink this fucking drink.
I forgave.
Drink the drink then.
I don't drink what you're drinking.
No, I'm trying to be facetious.
I know, but nobody trying to poison nobody. My thing is, the door is there. If you feel like it's complicated, there you go.
But why? Are you
going but then for you to sit here and say that, oh, you never loved them. I feel like that's that guilt trip shit men do, to that manipulative shit and that fucking.
You all close on the mic too. Go ahead, girl. Go ahead. Keep talking.
That manipulative fucking fucking.
Can't even get a word together.
I can't even get it together. Can't even get a word. What is it called? That the reverse psychology shit. Trying to put it on the woman as always. Because men never really want to take responsibility for their shit.
That's.
Never.
No men. They never want to. A man has to take responsibility.
A lot of them don't. Well,
if he stepped out. Listen, if a man steps out, how can he not take responsibility?
They don't.
Adults, you make an adult decision to do something. How can you not take responsibility for it?
You don't.
Of course, listen. Of course, there's going to be some factors, and those are the factors that really should have been discussed prior to one of the parties. Because you keep saying men. Like, women don't do it, but one of the parties
making the decision. I know women do it. You have some slime ball ass bitches out here. I know that.
Why they gotta be a slime ball?
Because, I mean, women out here are bitches too.
It might be something missing in their
relationship.
It's not being,
I don't feel like there's anything missing. Prince Charming came by. It's just wanting your cake and eating it too, and you want to sit there and play these fucking games. That's all I'm saying. Because at the end of the day, a lot of them are just all lies. They're lies.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been.
Yeah, we're gonna let it go because we went really over. Topic. It's really not a serious topic. Like I'm just saying. Like, yeah, like you already said. Like, I'm super guarded, and I have my reasons to be guarded.
You do.
Yeah, men just put a bad taste in my mouth right now.
Really?
Not in a good way. Not in a good fucking way. I'm literally probably close. Just switching to lesbianism.
You better not say that.
Switching to lesbianism. Because I just like, I can't, and I don't want to.
I have nothing against it, but really, Tosh.
Why is that really?
You think it's going to change anything?
I'm not going to say it's going to change anything. It's just like, I just don't have the energy to do the bullshit all over. All
right.
Anyway, because I just don't care anymore.
All right, Tosh. Well,
like I told you, I'm prepared to be by myself.
Are we going to end this one in prayer?
I'm prepared.
We're going to end this session in prayer.
I'm prepared. Come on. Just me and my hog.
All right, question, and then we out of here. So, if you had one lesson, huh?
Nothing. Go ahead.
We over time? You don't want to
no,
do
you can go ahead and right. do the question.
If you have one place where you're getting ready to get the electric chair, and you have one place you want a milkshake from before you plug the chair in, where would what place would that be?
I don't know. Ice cream parlor in St. Thomas. And I had a strawberry.
You milkshake. Think they're going to go all the way fucking plane.
It was really good.
And fly to St. Thomas to get you a milkshake. So you are out your tree.
Oh my God. I don't really like milkshakes like that. I definitely don't want them down. I don't want Wendy's only got Frosties. I would eat a fryer Frosty though. Because I don't know anybody that make any good milkshakes.
Okay, mine's would be Nifty Fifties.
I never had a Nifty Fifty.
Oh, check. You haven't had a Nifty Fifty.
I'll go there one You're day. Missing. I'll take me on a date.
This girl, I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you.
It's right next to Starbucks.
I swear.
I'll
Treat
take
yourself.
I'm,
gonna
of course I'm gonna
you like butterscotch crimpets?
Sure.
Best milkshake in Nifty Fifties. They got really? Butterscotch crimpets.
Butterscotch crimpets.
They make the milkshake and they crush a butterscotch crimpet up in it. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Now
thank
that we
you.
Thank
I
you.
Me a question, but I don't have one.
No, you never have a question.
I never have a question. So he'll be doing the questions for now. Why don't you ask two? Ask two, since I don't know.
No, I don't. I'm sick of you.
You sick of me? What did I do?
I'm messing with you. I'm just messing with you.
Why can't I be me?
You are. And nobody can stop you from being you. You are who you are. I'm not trying to stop you from being you. Listen, I know when I leave, you know what I mean? When this is over, you and Bob can go party.
I'm not even interested in Bob right now.
Take a nap.
Bob's the last thing. But I'm gonna smoke.
You need some sleep. That's what it is.
Yeah, I am a little tired.
That's what it is. You need some sleep.
No, I'm gonna sleep. I'm gonna upload.
Pause.
I'm gonna upload the first episode.
Oh, okay. I got scared. What the heck is that?
No, I'm gonna finish my garlic bread.
And unpack.
I'm not unpacking shit. That shit ain't getting touched to the weekend.
Oh my god.
That shit gonna sit right the fuck on that floor. I don't care. I got dishes too.
How you come back to dishes? But anyway.
No, I mean, I cooked yesterday.
Oh.
It was Sunday.
Anyway, folks, like and share. As you can see, some of our topics are very serious and not controversial, but they touch some serious issues. And this is what we want from you guys. We want you guys to come in and talk to us about it because you may have a different perspective on what I said or maybe what she said.
Nobody likes what I said. No man likes what I fucking say, and I don't give a fuck.
We got Trucker T over here. like and share. You know what I mean? Hit that thumbs up. And we'll be back next week.
Oh, you
meant
suck ass. I'm sorry.
I don't know what to do with her, man. I don't know what kind of dude she yells at her such ass. But that's how she feels.
So I'm going to lock y'all in a cage and torture you. Like, that's what I want to do.
All five men, right?
And no, it's me and a lot of women that want to do that shit. A lot of women.
Women want to be loved.
No, it's women out here that women are. Want ladies. Hell, you ain't even been on TikTok lately.
TikTok is love connection.
You be sending me that post for the chick on Instagram. She be talking the same.
She does speak too. Some real. I sent it to you because
yeah,
she speaks some
but
real.
It's like, that's what I
hear her perspectives and it makes me think. So
it makes you think because at the end of the day, you are a real fucking man.
Oh my god.
These are little fucking boys that are damaged and wants to put their insecurities on other motherfucking people.
We love y'all.
I don't.
We're out. She loves you. She's getting ready to go see her nephew, and she's going to smile. And
I'm smiling everything. Now, baby.
No, she, on the inside, she's like 175 degrees. She's an air fryer right now.
I really am not.
It's written on your face. Look.
What? I am fine. It's no hostility. Okay. I'm not even upset about anything.
Okay.
I'm just stating facts.
I got you.
You see, you always hitting some damn buttons.
I ain't hit no buttons. That's that crow sitting on the thing.
Turn your big ass around and get the fuck back to your fucking seat. The fuck is wrong with your ashy ass?
My ass ain't ashy.
It probably is.
Shit.
Probably is. You know, nobody know what man lotions they ass.
I got Carol's daughter on my ass. You don't even know what that is.
I do know what Carol's daughter is. I do. I'm a woman. Why wouldn't I know that?
Okay.
They make shampoo, body wash, all that shit.
You look like a Jergens girl. Anyway,
I'm bad for body work. All day.
I'll talk to y'all later. I'm done. I can't.
Whatever. Bye, y'all.
Bye, y'all.
Have a nice weekend.
Have a nice weekend.